Hello friends, today we are going to start with examination finding of aortic regurgitation. But before going to start, we must know about what is aortic regurgitation. So it is a valvular heart disease and in which there is a failure of aortic wall closed tightly. That's why it causes backflow of blood into the left ventricle. And this condition is called as aortic regurgitation. Guys, it's my personal request to make a habit of note down all those important points, because just watching a video may inculcate laziness and you might be sleepy. So we are going to start with our actual point, that is examination finding of chronic aortic regurgitation. So in which the first point is demucent sign. In demucent sign, there is a head bobbing with each heartbeat. That is, there is a head bobbing to and fro movements. So it is due to the ballistic effect of severe aortic regurgitation. We are going from top to bottom. So first we have seen the forehead, and in forehead there is also another sign, that is lighthouse sign. And in lighthouse sign, there is an alternate flushing and blanching of the forehead. We have two signs, that is the demucent sign and the another one is lighthouse sign. So after the forehead, we have the eyes, and we have next sign, that is Landolfi's sign. Landolfi's sign, and in which there is a pulsation in the pupils. So in eyes, we have pulsation in the pupils. Then we have the Baker's sign. In Baker's sign, there is a retinal artery pulsation. So in eyes, we have the two signs, that is the Landolfi's sign and the Baker's sign. So basically, we are going from top to bottom, that is in descending order. So we cover forehead, then eyes, and in mouth we have eula. Look over here, this is eula, and in severe aortic regurgitation there is a pulsation in the eula. So this sign is called as Muller sign. We have another sign in the mouth, that is Quinques sign. And what happened in the Quinques sign is, there is a capillary pulsation of the lip. So this can also be seen in the nail beds. It is called as the Quinques sign. So in mouth we have two signs, that is the Muller sign and the another one is Quinques sign. Now moving toward our next examination finding, and look over this video. Could you appreciate something which was happening in this video? Yes, there is a pulsation in the carotid, and it is called as dancing carotid. And this sign is known as Corrigan's sign, and in which we also can see the water hammer pulse. Our next sign is apex beat heaving thrill, and it can be seen in both, that is in diastole as well as in systole. In diastole, it can be seen in left lower sternal border, and in systole it can be seen in suprasternal angle, in suprasternal. Okay, now what do you think, or what is your opinion, that there is presence of S2, or S2 might be absent, or it might be soft? What do you think? Yes, S2 is not hard, or it can be soft. So this can be seen in the severe aortic regurgitation. S2 is hard when aortic and pulmonary wall get closes, and this defect is related to the aortic wall. So S2 is might be soft, or it cannot be heard. The next finding is, and it is very important, that is the murmur. Which murmur you are going to heard in this condition? Okay, I will give you a simple hint. Listen this sound carefully. So what do you think, which murmur you heard in this sound clip? Yes, we have early diastolic murmur. Now moving toward our next examination finding, let's clear our basics first. So if we take the BP of the upper limb and the lower limb, in normal individual, let's take an example. If the upper limb BP is 120 by 80 mm of HG and the lower limb is 140 by 80 mm of HG. Basically, there is difference of less than 20 mm of HG in the normal individuals. But if the difference is more than 20 mm of HG, then there is a positive Hill sign. So in aortic regurgitation, there is a positive Hill sign. Now our next sign is Durojes sign. And in Durojes sign, if you press your femoral artery with your stethoscope and heard the sound, you can actually heard to and fro murmur. After that, we have two signs, that is Rosenberg sign and the Gerhard's sign. So in Rosenberg sign, we have pulsations of the liver, and in Gerhard's sign, we have the pulsations of the enlarged spleen. So we have got pulsation of the both, that is the spleen and the liver. Yes? Okay, last examination finding of the severe aortic regurgitation is Trobes sign. And what's happening in that sign is, if you press over the femoral artery with your stetho and heard the sound, you will actually get the sound of pistol shot. So there is a pistol shot sound heard over the femoral artery. So this is all about the examination finding, in which we covered the Demoscene sign, Lighthouse sign, Landolfi's sign, Baker's sign, Muller sign, Quinque's sign. Then we covered the Corrigan's sign, that is the dancing carotid. Then we cover apex beat having thrill, S2 is not heard. Then murmur, that is the early diastolic murmur, Hill sign, Durojes sign, Rosenberg sign. Then we cover the Gerhard's sign and the Trobes sign. So this is all important signs for your examination finding of severe aortic regurgitation. Keep watching and stay updated with the Medicos. Thank you.